My story begins with an end. My parents divorced when I was 8, and this wasn't the first time they had been through a divorce. This was actually their second failed marriage apiece. Childhood for me, although had its joys, was really filled with anxiety and instability and letdowns. My dad was an alcoholic, and that played a major role in his two failed marriages. And like many families plagued with alcohol, there were bitter fights and emotional trauma. Although my parents did their best to love me and my brother, right from the beginning of my life, I was longing for emotional voids to be met. Church was not a part of my life growing up, so when a friend invited me to church when I was 13 years old, it was God's plan that I go and hear the gospel for the first time that night. I knew nothing of Jesus except of what was described that night. He was loving and accepting. He didn't care where I came from or what my family was like. He would never abandon me. He would always forgive me, and he would stand in my place at the judgment of God, and by grace, I would have eternal life. Choosing to accept Christ that night was the beginning of my redemption plan. I wish I could say from that moment on, I obediently followed Christ. But like most women, I have struggles, some so big that I question whether I'll ever get over them. I was a product of this world. My moral standards came from what our culture says is right and what is wrong. My influences were so secular, and my desires were self-centered. So I wasn't transformed overnight. God's plan for me has been consistent as he's been stripping me of my deeply ingrained worldliness into eternal desires. I picked up some habits growing up in my dysfunctional, blended, and unsettled family that have been really hard to shake. First, I can put on a front. I could leave the mess at home and prove to the outside world that I was not only fine, but that I have it all together. Still struggle with this one today. I'm pegged as the one who's always on top of it, and it's not true. I'm actually quite a mess at times. Another trait I picked up along the way is the one of shame. For example, having a godly marriage and raising children to know the Lord is new to me and my husband. We've never done this before, and it wasn't modeled to us as we were growing up. So we're clueless at times in our household. I'm afraid that people will judge me and my family because of where I've come from. And one other struggle I can thank my roots for: I really want to please you, and I really want you to like me. If you would have told me that part of my story would include working in leadership at a church in Chicago, leading other women to the throne of grace, I wouldn't have believed you. I would have said, that's crazy. There's no way that God could use my mistakes, my background, my insecurities for the purpose of leading other women. But that's the coolest part about how God can redeem our story. It's that we cannot dream it up. Now my job is to tell you about my baggage and my dysfunctional family. Transparency is practically my job description. The shame is fading, and the insecurities, although still there, are being filled by my security in Christ. God's story for me is still unfolding, but this I know: I have been redeemed.